previously on Uprising and Superstar Mayhem.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to AWF School.
Hold on, we're not done here. Maverick Brothers, you want your title shot? Well, get out here right now and you've got one.
Wait, what?
The new AWF Tag Team Champions.
Broken, wait a minute.
Wait a damn minute. Look at this. He's got this submission maneuver locked in. You see, Thompson, he's struggling. Referee, get JMI off of Brent Thompson.
AJ Young, you are on my hit list. After I take out that jive turkey, Travis Sparks, I'm going right after you, baby. Right after you, sucker.
Wait a minute. Speaking of JMI, there he is. He's attacking Tanker.
You know what he did? You all remember he attempted murder. He was an attempted murderer, which is a sin. Michael and I will make your lives hell on earth.
So, I'd like to take my time to interview Mrs. Ben Hitman herself, coming down to the ring by her government name, Sarah Hartford.
Well, I guess she's here. Here comes the wife of Ben Hitman, Sarah Hartford.
Did Ben Hitman knock up that...
Unfortunately, the rumors are true.
I believe I have a perfect way to fix this problem.
Wait a minute! Hold the phone, wait a minute! I know that music! Oh my god, ladies and gentlemen! That is Chris Hartford! That is the brother of Ben Hitman!
Wait!
And everyone to jump him! Wait! Chris Hartford! There it is! There it is! It throws him over the top rope! Chris Hartford is through NWO Free Life over the top rope! He had enough of NWO Free Life shenanigans ruining his family's name! My goodness, ladies and gentlemen, this is epic! Glad to see him back!
You know who I'm talking to, NWO for your life. Me and you have business to attend to. At CyberSlam, I'm gonna take your ass out just like somebody should have did a long time ago.
Turn around. Wait a minute! Stunner! He got the stunner! NWO for your life stuck up behind him and stunned Nate the Great! He flips him off him.
And there's a second maple knee.
Whoa, wait a minute, that's AJ Young. AJ Young, look at this, he's continuing his assault on Charlie.
Wait.
Hitman's back in the ring, and Hitman's attacking AJ Young. My god, just close on Young outside the ring. He came to the aid of Sean Riley.
I am Danny Hardy, and I am your champion. I am your king. I am your leader. And I will defeat your hero at CyberSlam. You see, your hero and myself, we have a very lengthy history with each other. It dates back for almost 2 years now. I'm just having some matches on Uprising. Fighting at King of the Ring events. Where I was beaten in the 2011 King of the Ring by your hero. I went on to the next King of the Ring And not only did I defeat your hero, but I became the king of the AWF. And after that, I became your champion. And what has your hero done since losing to me? Absolutely nothing. Nothing at all. All he did was lose to Bully Nate. While I'm here, still the AWF champion, leader of the Kings of Call. Some people a year ago may have looked at Ben Hitman as being the guy of AWF, being the number one face here, but you know what? You're all damn wrong today, because I am the number one guy. I am the number one face. I am the face of the AWF. I proved it when I won King of the Ring. I proved it when I became AWF champion. And I'm going to prove it again when I take out your hero at CyberSlam. Because Ben Hitman, you may look at this as your chance at redemption, your chance to become champion again through all the personal shit you've been through in these last few months. You know how I look at this match? I don't look at it that way. I look at it as a chance to finally prove to everyone, prove to all the haters, and prove to them that I am better than you. I am the face of this company. And that you are no longer needed here. You've been replaced. This is no longer your company, Ben Hitman. This is mine. And I understand now that for you to go away, you're not just going to walk away because you've been through personal shit before. It's not going to make you go away. What's going to make you go away is when I punch you in the skull at CyberSlam. Take you out once and for all, and we never have to see you again.
Danny, I'm not going to come out here and give you a 10-minute response to what you just said. I'm not going to go on and talk about how much I hate you or how I'm going to take you out or whatever you think I'm going to do. I'm simply going to put it like this. Have I been through a lot of personal stuff as of late? Yes. And you know what, Danny, this has nothing to do with our championship match, because right now, I'm not concerned with that issue. I'll deal with that later on. However, I am dealing with this championship match right now. You see, it's been damn too long since I've been AWF champion. Damn too long. In fact, it was the last CyberSlam which I lost my AWF championship. I was never able to regain it. But you see, at this CyberSlam, I will regain my AWF championship. I will be the AWF champion again. You see, I'm not going in there to try to prove that I'm the face of this company. I'm not going in there to prove that I'm the number one guy, because that's a matter of opinion. If you think I'm the number one guy, yeah, I thank you, but I'm not going to brag about it. Maybe I'll brag once I become AWF champion, because as far as I see it, since I lost that AWF championship, I have not been the number one guy. But at CyberSlam, I will be the champion again.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to AWF versus ACCE Super Show. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's episode will serve as Uprising episode 43 and Superstar Mayhem episode 14. This is a Super Show, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Phil Ponterio, and I'm excited. AWF, ACCE, one show here tonight. This is the final show until CyberSlam, and at CyberSlam, the tag team titles will be defended. But we do not know who the Maverick Brothers will be defending those tag team titles against. We're going to find out in a few moments, as this opening match here tonight is a number one contenders match for the world tag team titles. So the American Patriots could be going to CyberSlam, and they could be the next tag team champions. They could be number one contenders after tonight. Or it could be these guys. AAA. Ireland and Stephen Smith. The other members, Alberto Jr. and Ramirez Sanchez. These guys want to take the tag team titles to AAA. These guys feel discriminated because they're not American. So they formed an alliance in the last few weeks. They've been pretty impressive. I gotta give them that. But we'll see how impressive they are tonight, when they could be number one contenders, but they have to defeat the American Patriots. And the referee calls for it all. Ladies and gentlemen, before we officially went on the air, Danny Hardy, Ben Hitman, my goodness, ladies and gentlemen, that was epic. The words those two used, everyone was just hooked by every word. It was unbelievable. I cannot wait to see them two go at it at CyberSlam when the AWF Championship is on the line. But we will also see them in our main event here tonight, as they will be on opposing teams, as the team of Ben Hitman and Sean Riley go up against the team of Danny Hardy and AJ Young. But that's a little bit later on tonight. Right now, it's been a pretty even matchup thus far between the two teams. Stephen Smith was a big dropkick. Smith, a former multiple-time mid-international champion,
former tag team champion in his own right. And another clothesline. You can see a fan holding a USA sign, obviously against AAA here. This big elbow drop right into the back. Ireland is now the legal man. Let's see what Ireland's gonna do here. Oh, Ireland knocks Johnson to the outside of the ring. Oh my goodness, double axe handle from off the apron right into the steel post. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Uh-oh. These guys are all fighting on the outside here. Andrew Justice. My goodness, just was taking it to both members of AAA. Wait a minute now. Ireland. He throws Johnson in the ring. One. Two. No. It's not enough. I thought he had it right there. But it was not enough. He got him in the ring. Quick, wait a minute. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10 punches. It sends Johnson right down to the ground. Irish whip. A clothesline in the corner. Multiple punches there by Ireland. Uh-oh. One was caught there. And a big clothesline. Johnson's got to get a tag. He's got to tag in his tag team partner. Right now, he's just taking it to one half of AAA here. Actually, one fourth. But in this match, one half. Wait, look at this snap suplex. Uh-oh. Big scoop slam right onto the ropes there. Irish whip in Ireland is now in the American Patriots corner. Look at this. What are these guys going to do? Uh-oh. Up he goes and... Oh! Big Samoan drop there by the American Patriots. He's got to go for a cover. One. Oh, only a one count. Perhaps they could have gotten a two, maybe even a three count. If there was no taunt in there. By Justice, but it cost him. These guys, especially these rookies, they do a lot of taunting, and it costs them many opportunities to win the match. And they don't realize they could win the match if they don't taunt. Maybe one day they'll realize it. And there's a big neck break. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight is AWF versus ACCE. This is our first ever Super Show. And what that means is they will not, Uprising and Superstar Mayhem will not have their each respective shows. Tonight the shows are merged into one. We're doing a Super Show. As this show happens, this will count for AWF Uprising episode 43 and Superstar Mayhem episode 14. In case you didn't understand, back to this match, and wait a minute, look at the American Patriots. Oh my god, Doomsday Device. Here's a cover. One, two, Only a two count. I thought that was gonna be it. Oh, win! The interference there by Stephen Smith allowed Ireland to capitalize. And there's a neck breaker. Ireland gets the tag to Stephen Smith. No. Double gut buster. Oh, what a move there. Triple A, new to the tag team scene here in AWF. This would be their first shot at the tag team titles if they become the number one contenders here tonight. The American Patriots, however, have had multiple opportunities in the past to become the tag team champions. And hopefully, if they win, this is their chance. But I don't know how many chances they got left. They might not even make it to CyberSlam after this match. Wait a minute. And yeah, I think Stephen Smith was signaling for a big slam there, but obviously Andrew Justice thought differently. Wait a minute. Snake eyes. Side headlock. The big side elbow. Right across the face. Oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the last show until AWF CyberSlam. Right now, we're going to find out who will be challenging for the tag team titles. And it could be the American Patriots. If they get the cover, win here, 1-2. No. They did not get the win, at least not yet. Whoever wins this match, the Maverick Brothers are going to have a tough tag team to defeat, if they can defeat them. Irish whip. Tag to Ireland. Wait a minute, he just throws him off the top rope! Big crossbody! Oh, those kicks. Wait a minute. Pile driver. Big pile driver there by Ireland. And a tag to Stephen Smith. The big clothesline. Uh-oh. Smith is signaling for it. He's got him up with his shoulders. And there's the power slam. Into the cover. Come on, wait a minute. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Triple A are the number one contenders for the tag team titles. Triple A will be going up against the Maverick Brothers at CyberSlam. First time becoming number one contenders. Will these guys be the next tag team champions? We'll find out at CyberSlam. Very impressive here tonight for these two.
Love us or hate us. What is right for us? We don't give a fuck anyway. Try to steal imagination from us. Things we believe in, we will never be.
train never betrayed.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to AWF versus ACCE Super Show. And ladies and gentlemen, the man you're seeing right there is the new Don Martin. Don Martin, now a member of the Kings of Call, looks completely different. And since joining the Kings of Call, some people have not been the biggest supporters of Don Martin. Take a look what AJ Young said on the official AWF Facebook page about it. You can ask to join the official AWF Facebook page, facebook.com/groups/American Wrestling Federation. Go ask to join the group. You will be accepted. You can get all the insider information regarding the AWF and the ACC and see interaction with all the superstars, including AJ Young and Don Martin.
Hold it now.
And also this man, Travis Sparks.
Come on, come on.
Travis Sparks, who's been having some issues with Von Dynamite as of late. Von Dynamite addressed him on the last AWF Uprising, episode 42. And it's been announced that these two will have a match at CyberSlam. It all started when they had a match on Uprising, which Travis Sparks picked up the victory. Von Dynamite obviously upset about that, and he's going to get his chance for redemption, his chance to defeat Travis Sparks if he can. But that's CyberSlam. We gotta see, can Travis Sparks defeat the new Don Martin? I must say, I'm really impressed in what the Kings Call have done with Don Martin. He looks more like a superstar compared to how he used to look. Don Martin has said that since joining the Kings of Call, they've reminded him about the person he's supposed to be. Growing up very wealthy. But he said along the way, he forgot who he was, but the Kings of Call reminded him who he was, and he's now the man he's supposed to be, the greater, richer man. Travis Sparks obviously does not share the same beliefs as Don Martin. Wait, look at this! Oh my goodness! Springboard over the top rope, but does not get anything. They call that high risk for a reason. Don Martin was lucky that he did not get hit with that. And now he's got the advantage here. Travis Sparks is going to be in a world of pain right now. And look at this! Springboard dropkick. Oh, there's a big kick. Now choking him with the middle rope. Big dropkick. A springboard. Back elbow. Into the cover. One. Only one count. Ladies and gentlemen, this match is going to be an epic match for sure. Both these men high flyers here in the AWF. Oh, what a move there. But also great technicians in the ring. Don Martin up on the middle rope. There's a big elbow drop. Into a cover. One. Only one. And again, choking him on that second rope. Martin up on the top. And oh! Went for a shooting star press, but Travis Sparks got out of the way. And look at this! Big headbutt right into the back of Don Martin. An arm drag! And there's a moonsault. Snap mirror and a dropkick. This match is now back in the control of Travis Sparks. Oh wait a minute, look at this. Sunset flip to a cover. One. Wait a minute, reversal. One, two. Oh my. Travis Sparks says that sunset flip, but it was reversed by Don Martin. My God, look at that! Just did a hurricane run off from the top rope. There's a drop kick. A big moonsault there from the top rope. A drop kick right in the back. Uh-oh, look at this. It's an airplane spin. I haven't seen this move used for years. And a big splash from the top rope. And a big shooting star press. And a drop kick. And an elbow right across the chest. Arm drag there by Travis. Uh-oh. Eric and Rana. Looked like Martin was in trouble there, but oh! Big knee. Kick right in the back. Big hurricane rana sends Martin right to the ground. Oh, kick. Oh, another kick. Oh, it sends Martin off the apron. Oh my God! Diving out of the ring with said hurricane rana. only a two count. I'm sorry for that, ladies and gentlemen. The receiving word for information that will be revealed later on tonight. Right now, Travis Sparks is a big pile driver. 1, 2, only a two count. Ladies and gentlemen, right here, right now, you're getting the best action in the world. Better than some New Jersey-based promotions or some Mount Pocono-based promotions. 2, the AWF. The future is now, and you're going to get the best of college wrestling. 1, 2, 3, no, only a two count. I saw a People Power sign up. And actually, the information, I'll tell you guys now. Big Johnny, John Laurinaitis, will be returning at CyberSlam, and he will be doing some interviews with many AWF NACC superstars. So stay tuned for that when Big Johnny is bringing People Power to the AWF. There's a drop kick. Oh, wait a minute. Look at the sunset flip! Oh, I thought he was going to go for a cover there, but he did not. Wait a minute. Is he going for another sunset flip? And this time he got the cover. 1, 2. Oh, only a two count. A big super kick there by Don Martin. Don Martin, I'm sure, would love to pick up a win here. Would make the Kings of Call very happy. And look at this. 1, 2, 3. Wait a minute. Uh-oh. Travis Sparks was the counter. 1. Oh, but lucky enough, Don Martin got the ropes. These guys just pulling roll-ups out of nowhere. Uh-oh, throw up that Kings of Claw taunt symbolizing the four members of the group. What's this? They close on. Oh, wait a minute. It looks like Don Martin was closing in for the victory. But Sparks is not gonna let that happen. Wait a minute! Look at this victory roll! 1, 2! Oh, wait a minute! Counter! 1, 2, 3! Don Martin has just won this match! Don Martin has just picked up a victory over Travis Sparks. This is huge for the Kings of Call. But how does Travis Sparks feel losing to Don Martin, especially this close to his match with Von Dynamite at CyberSlam? I know Don Martin is very happy with that win. I'm very happy to give a win to the Kings of Call. Wait, speaking of win, there's Von. Von Dynamite. Whoa, Travis, he's telling him to come down there. Wait, Von's saying to come up here. Wait a minute. Uh-oh. There's John Laurinaitis. He's going to be doing interviewing at CyberSlam. Wait a minute. What's going on here? Oh, we got security. These guys, it look like they're going to go. Wait a minute. Sparks just threw the first punch. Von! Von, it's a big punch there.
Whoa. Look who it is. Chris Hart. Well, it looks like he went corporate. I mean, I guess this is what happens when been gone for so long, but... Man, how you doing?
Doing good. Enjoying being general manager.
That's great. That's great, man. It's great. Listen. Since you're the general manager, you need to do me a favor. Yeah, a really big one.
Sure. What is it?
See,
you know this punk NWO for your life, and he's pissed just about everybody off a million times, and he's been very personal with my family, and I know you know that. And look, my brother, he's not gonna do anything, at least right now. He wants to be champion, and you know that's fine. That's fine. And go for being champion. But he's not gonna address his personal stuff. Somebody has to. So that's why I made my comeback on Superstar Mayhem, sure you saw. And you know what? I think I need to get in the ring soon again, but this time for an official match.
Whoa. Are you physically able to get into the ring? I mean, well, you're retired. What happened? The doctor said you can't.
Forget what the doctor said. This isn't a fight. This isn't a doctor issue. This is just something I need to do. Consider it this. It's not me coming out of retirement. This is just a fight. An unsanctioned fight. Put it like that. You need to let me do this. And I don't know this kid much, but I know he will fight me. I know that much. So come on. Help me out. Come on, we're old friends here. You know, if the situations were reversed, I'd do the same for you. Remember, come on. When I was the general manager, I helped you out. Come on, you owe me on this one.
Whoa. You got a point. So you know what? You got it. Tonight, on Uprising, Superstar Mayhem, AWF Super Show, Chris Hartford steps in the ring one more time to take on the ACCE, United States Champion, NWO for your life. You're welcome.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Hartford is stepping back into the ring later tonight, going up against NWO for your life. We just heard it in the general manager's office. Jack Williams just confirmed that match will happen later on tonight. Right now, Big Dwayne is making his way down to the ring for a match with the Extreme Tyler. Big Dwayne has a match with Chris Core at CyberSlam. You can see what Chris Core has done to Big Dwayne in these last few weeks. But they've all been sneak attacks and attacks when Big Dwayne was not 100%. We'll see if Big Dwayne will be 100% at CyberSlam. But tonight, he's going up against his former Kings of Call partner, the Extreme Tyler. Now, you've seen the Kings of Call of today. JMI, Don Martin, Danny Hardy, Dynamite. But the original Kings of Call included people like the Extreme Tyler and Big Dwayne. And having Rockville and Dynamite. But if since the original Kings of Call have gone their separate ways, the Extreme Tyler and Big Dwayne became fan favorites here in AWF. Fans love these guys. It's going to be interesting to see who they'll be cheering here tonight. Will they be cheering for Tyler? Will they be cheering for Big Dwayne? Referee calls for the bell. A lot of respect between these two men. A lot of similarities, as I said before. Both former Kings of Call members. Both fan favorites. Both former Money in the Bank holders. And both former AWF champions. And I'm sure both of these men will be AWF champion one day in the future. And if there's a big clothesline by Big Dwayne. Big Dwayne actually was the previous champion right before the current champion Danny Hardy became AWF champion. Extreme Tyler obviously winning his title back at CyberSlam 2011. And interesting, both of these men won their world championships by cashing in the Money in the Bank briefcase. And the big clothesline. Kick. Big kick. Kick. Irish whip. And a hip toss. Oh man. Big drop kick there. And tornado DDT. And a big swanton bomb there by the Extreme Tyler. And a springboard crossbody. Fans getting behind the Extreme One. Oh, what a move there. Wait a minute. Where's Tyler going? He's going up. Oh! Big Dwayne dodges a dropkick. And look at this big slam. Was Big Dwayne singling for a big clothesline? Uh-oh, he's gonna give a big power slam again. Yes, he is. What's this? Big backbreaker. Takes him to the corner. Now look at his shoulder thrusts there. A fallaway slam. Elbow right in the back of the head. Oh, knocks Tyler right down. It's a big shot. Wait, look at this. Belly to belly suplex. One, two, only a two count. Look at this. Scoop slam right onto the ropes. Oh. Whoa. Tyler very close to falling off the apron. Well, look at this. And suplex right back into the ring. It almost seemed like Big Dwayne did not want to knock Tyler off of that apron. And, oh, geez, he knocked him off that time with authority. Tyler came crashing right at my announce table. And no, double axe handle right, jumping off the apron. Knees right into the gut with German suplex. Lewis. Damn, the Extreme Tiger just threw Big Dwayne right into the ring. Who would have thought he would have thrown him in? Whoa. What's he looking to do here? Oh, and this is more like the Extreme Tiger we're used to. Oh, and a springboard body splash. Is this going to be enough to keep Big Dwayne down? Two? No, only a two count. Clothesline. A big elbow drop. Oh, he missed the springboard crossbody. A belly-to-belly suplex. And he puts him up on the top rope. Oh, knocks him down. And look at this suplex right back into the ring. He's got him up on the top rope there. What's he doing? It's superplex! Superplex there by Big Dwayne. Uh-oh. Look at this. Powerbomb time. One's not enough. And two. My god. And three. Maybe. I think one was enough. Two. What? Three powerbombs of Big Dwayne? That's not enough to keep the Extreme Tiger down? This is unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. What's Tyler doing? Whoa! Dodge the clothesline. A big elbow right across the chest. Shane Tyler, he could be putting Big Dwayne away. Right now he's doing all the right things. There's a drop kick. Oh, what a move there. And a Hurricane Rana. Oh my god. Look at this, Uranaki. But wait, Big Dwayne suplexes Tyler back into the ring before the Extreme One could do anything. And Tyler, that was the reversal. Neckbreaker. Springboard body splash. Uh-oh, and Tyler up on the top. Swanton Bomb. And look at this, Whisper in the Wind! And usually after a Whisper in the Wind, this means it's time for the Extreme Tyler Bomb. Yes, it is. It's got him up. And there it is! There's the Extreme Tyler Bomb. One, two, three! The Extreme Tyler just picked up a big victory here over Big Dwayne. The Extreme Tyler has just picked up a huge victory here on this super show. That's definitely got to impress many, many people, and hopefully impress the general manager, Jack Williams. Maybe we could see a title shot for the Extreme Tyler in the future. And Big Dwayne, he's up. Wait a minute, that's Chris Core! Chris Core is the steel pot! What the? Damn it, Core!
Mike Ryder. At CyberSlam, I will defeat you. I will put you down for the count of three. But you see, the reason why this match is happening is not my fault. You have this belief that I try to murder you, try to burn you, and that is as far from the truth. I did nothing to you. Carnage. It was not me who lit the fire. I was there. I was actually about to make my way down to the ring until that happened. And just because I was there, the cameras caught my face and blamed me. When it wasn't me, for months I was blamed for taking out Mike Ryder, putting him in the hospital. And normally I don't mind being credited for taking people out. In this case, I don't like it because it wasn't really me. I did nothing to you, Mike Ryder. Which is why when you returned and you attacked me, you're the reason why we have any kind of rivalry. Because of your absurd beliefs. Because of your attack on me. I don't take attacks too lightly. And another thing I would like to address, you're now guided by this Reverend Joseph, and I hope you know what you're getting yourself into, Mike. You see, this man is a dangerous, dangerous man. You might be thinking, how can he be a dangerous man? He's a reverend. But I know this man, and this man knows me. That story he told you on Uprising was absolutely bullshit. All of it. This man, he was a reverend at my church when I was a kid. Just like you, Mike, I thought he was a great man. Until I heard some things. Until I saw some things. But you see, Mike, I'm not going to tell you what I saw. I'm not going to tell you because you're going to find out one day. I'm going to make him tell you who he really is. Because after I defeat you, I'm going to grab that reverend by the throat, throw his ass in the ring, and I'm going to make him spill the beans. I'm going to make him tell you that he isn't this great holy man. He's nothing but scum.
Ladies and gentlemen, at CyberSlam, Sean Walsh, Sock 105, the owner of the AWF, will make an announcement regarding the main event of Call All Stars 5. That'll open up CyberSlam, ladies and gentlemen.
All I've heard this week is
why, JMI? Why did you attack Thompson? Why did you tear his ACL? What happened? I've heard these kind of questions from the people, from the likes of Phil Bontario, to people backstage, to the fan. And my answer to that is because he is a weak link. He was the weakest link in the Kings of Call. He is a weakling, and he didn't deserve to be associated with me, Dynamite, Danny Hardy, and now the newest member, Don Martin. Brett Thompson. Before I get on this, I just want to let you know that that's the last time people will see you on Uprising, because as of right now, because I own your contract, you are fired. I don't want to see you back on Uprising ever again, and you won't ever be back here. And the reason he was a weak link was because look at Pain for Pride, for example. Who in their right mind, when they get to the top of the cell and can win the match and retain their U.S. title, jumps off the top of the cell like an idiot? Nobody in the right sense of mind, nobody that should be in the Kings of Call. Because all the Kings of Call worry about is winning, getting the gold, being the best. That wasn't what Brett Thompson was worrying about. He was worrying about pleasing you disgusting fans. And that's not something the Kings of Call want. That's not something that we can cause to have in our group. No. That's why I want to talk to Don Martin. Because Don Martin, on the other hand, wants to win. He's all about the money, which is a good thing. He, on the hand, wanted to join us. And later tonight, you will see the new and improved Don Martin. The man who will do better than Brent Thompson will have ever done. He will be the next junior heavyweight champion and will bring that title to the AWF and add one more piece of gold to the Kings of Call to prove that we are the most dominant and better than the original versions of the Kings of Call ever. And now that I've got done with the other topics, let me move on to another man that I haven't had the opportunity to talk about, but I got to reacquaint myself with last week. Tank. Dave Tank. Whatever you like to call yourself. Anyway, whatever way you call yourself, you are still not as good as me. And you will know that on CyberSlam when I make you tap out and tear your ACL.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen, here on this epic AWF versus ACCE Super Show. And then coming out to the ring right now is the former AWF champion, Christopher Wonder. Christopher Wonder, you know, I have to admit, he hasn't done that well since losing his AWF championship. I mean, hasn't done bad, but it just seems like he's not at the level he used to be anymore. And I think Christopher Wonder realizes that, which is why I bet you tonight he's gonna work his ass off to try to prove that he needs to be, excuse me, that he wants to be champion again. He wants to prove that he deserves to be AWF champion. And the man to prove is Jack Williams, and understand, from what I'm understanding, Jack Williams is paying attention closely to his match to watch Christopher Wonder and to watch his opponent, CJ Hawkins. CJ Hawkins only making his debut a few short weeks back. But CJ Hawkins, he's had a long career already. He's a legend in quite a few car shows and looks to become a legend in the AWF. Started off to a great start. Pinning Brock Manson. Yeah, he had a match on the AWF Old School. Was not so successful, but still, he was in the ring as the ACC champion. And now, tonight, he's up against Christopher Wonder. CJ Hawkins, he wants to prove that he deserves an AWF championship match here tonight. And because Jack Williams is paying attention closely to this match, apparently, after this match, once this match is over, he has a big announcement right after this match is over. I have no idea what the announcement will be. We'll find out after this match. And here we go. Hawkins and Wonder lock up. Front face lock, and there's a European uppercut. Off the ropes, and look at this. Oh, look at that counter there by Christopher Wonder. Wait, now CJ Hawkins. It looked like Wonder was trying to get the upper hand there, but he did not have it for long. Hawkins back in control here. And the kicks of CJ Hawkins. Those kicks are so painful. And you can see Christopher Wonder showing how painful they are. And oh, jeez. Look at this. Oh my god, it was like a suplex to a DDT. CJ Hawkins, this guy has got to have one of the best move sets in the entire call world. I mean, he pulled off moves like that and this. I mean, it's amazing the stuff this guy can do. He's an amazing high flyer. He's great in the ring. He's a very technical guy at times. His kicks are great. And the drop kick was great. And he pretty much has everything you need to be successful, and that's probably why he's been so successful in call wrestling. And big roundhouse kick right there by CJ Hawkins. This is going to be enough to keep Wonder down. Two, only a two count. And there's a big enziguri. Oh my god, springboard reverse DDT. And there's that leg drop. Oh man, he just missed that corkscrew from the top rope. Christopher Wonder was not able to get up. Oh, wait a minute, but that allowed him. Maybe he played possum there for CJ Hawkins. And look at these vicious clotheslines by Christopher Wonder. Wonder known for his clotheslines, and he's putting them to the effect right here on CJ Hawkins. Uh-oh. And there's a neckbreaker. Oh And a double underhook backbreaker. There's another neckbreaker by Christopher Wonder. Wonder now with some punches. What's Christopher Wonder doing? Oh, big stomp there. Using the ropes for leverage. Multiple punches there by the man that was formerly undefeated in his rookie year in the American Wrestling Federation. Oh, big knee drop there. And there's a big back suplex. Side headlock there by Christopher Wonder, and a side headlock takedown. A knee drop. This is where Wonder likes his opponents down on the ground. There's a big elbow drop, which is very rare from Christopher Wonder to go to that top rope. But the point I was trying to make, Wonder is known for his strikes and moves like this to keep his opponent down. He likes his opponent grounded. One, two, three. No, I thought it was going to be a three count. It was very close, but CJ Hawkins able to kick out. There's a big roundhouse kick. Oh, kick right in the gut. And then look at this. There's that leg drop by CJ Hawkins. CJ Hawkins regaining the control in this match, but you got to keep in mind the damage he took there from Christopher Wonder for at least a few minutes there. You gotta wonder what toll that took on him. Oh, did you see that? Brainbuster! Brainbuster by CJ Hawkins. And look at this! Oh my god! Is this gonna put him away? One, two, three. No! Only a two count! And there's a drop kick! Uh oh. Here's some of these kicks. And there's a roundhouse kick. It looks like CJ Hawkins has got something else in mind. Look at this. Shining Wizard. These fans are on their feet. Is this going to be enough to keep Wonder down? One, two, only a two count. Oh my god. Raymond, oh! Hawkins took too long to get to the top rope and is on Christopher Wonder to do this big superplex. You gotta wonder now, that mistake there by CJ Hawkins, was that the mistake that's gonna cost him this match? Wonder is known for capitalizing on mistakes. And look at this. Oh, big Olympic slam there. Into a cover. One, two, three. Only a two count. CJ Hawkins is still holding on. Uh-oh. But he might not be for much longer. There's a big pile driver. Vintage Christopher Wonder. One, two, three. No, only two. Wait a minute. CJ Hawkins. Look at this. Hurricane Rana. Now big moonsault. What does CJ got in mind here? Oh! Big leg drop from the top rope! Uh-oh. Look at this! Look at the submission move he's got applied! This is unbelievable! I believe it's the cattle mutilation. Flexibility there. Oh my god, by CJ Hawkins. Will Christopher Wonder tap out? No, he does not. Uh-oh, Hawkins is signaling for the end. And that's exactly what he's doing! Signifying the end there for Christopher Wonder as he hits that big pedigree. 1, 2, 3! CJ Hawkins picks up the victory. CJ Hawkins has just defeated the former AWF champion, Christopher Wonder. Congratulations to CJ Hawkins. Big win for CJ here. I'm getting word now that we're getting the cameras back in General Manager Jack Williams' office. He's got a big announcement.
Hold on 1 second. See, we've already announced that I have some big announcement regarding CyberSlam. And I do. I'm going to make that announcement right now. You see, at CyberSlam, the AWF Championship will be defended. Danny Hardy, Ben Hitman, we already know that. But after CyberSlam, we need a new number one contender. That's exactly what we're going to get. Because you see, there's going to be a triple threat match at CyberSlam between CJ Hawkins, Christopher Wonder, and the Extreme Tyler. See, those three were put to the test tonight to see who would make this match. It was originally going to be a singles match, but you three impressed me so much that I had to make this a triple threat match. And whoever wins, Wonder, Hawkins, Tyler, whichever one of you three win the match, will be the number one contender for the AWF Championship on the Uprising right after CyberSlam. So whoever wins, you'll fight the champion, whether it be Hardy, Hitman, on AWF Uprising episode 44. I wish the best of luck to you three men, and I'm excited for whichever main event we're going to have on the next AWF Uprising.
Oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen, that was a huge announcement there by Jack Williams. At CyberSlam, Christopher Wonder, CJ Hawkins, the Extreme Tyler, triple threat match. The winner is the number one contender for the AWF Championship, and they get that title opportunity on the next AWF Uprising, episode 44. Coming down to the ring, right, actually about to get into the ring, is ACCE's Europe. One of the men who will be in the Elimination Chamber match at CyberSlam, and he's going up against a man who will also be in the Elimination Chamber match at CyberSlam, Ty Q. These guys both want to be ACCE champion. They can be champions if they win the Elimination Chamber match at CyberSlam. it interesting? These guys had a stare down a few weeks back on Superstar Mayhem, and now they're going to get to go one-on-one here tonight. Both these guys have great respect for each other, but when it comes to the ACCE Championship, both of you guys will do whatever it takes to be champion. And a big flapjack there by Ty Q. Ty Q, the former co-owner of the AWF. Europe, a former AWF United States champion. Wait, what's this? DDT there by Europe. Wait a minute. Is he gonna do another one? Yes, he is. Uh-oh. Block that one. A big drop kick there by Ty Q. You know, personally, in that chamber match, I'm pulling for Dynamite. Because Dynamite, he's from the AWF. And we want the ACCE Championship. They took our US belt. So why don't we take their world title belt? Dynamite can do it. But he's got a lot of obstacles to face in that chamber match. Including the chamber itself. Irish whip right into the corner. A shoulder thrust here by Europe. A lot of people are picking Europe to win the Elimination Chamber match at SummerSlam. Some people see it as it's his chance. It's his time to be champion. And it very well could be. I hope it's not, because I want Dynamite to win. But I cannot deny it may be Europe's time to be champion, and he may be winning that at the belt at SummerSlam. But then again, some people say Ty Q is going to walk out the winner. Some people say, including me, say Dynamite. Some people say the Sandman Brock Manson. Some people say Ice. Some people even say Alberto Jr. You know, anything can happen. And there's a big DDT there by Europe. It's interesting to note that Europe had a match with Ramirez Sanchez in the last episode of Superstar Mayhem. You gotta wonder what effect that has on his body. I mean, Ramirez Sanchez, 7 foot tall, 350 plus pounds. Definitely helps out everybody else in the chamber. Wait, Ty Q just knocked Europe to the outside of the ring. We'll dive over the top rope. Now we'll right to the throat there. There's a drop kick. Look at that! My goodness! Big move there by Ty Q. Is he looking to put Europe away? One, two, only a two count. The back body drop. And A backbreaker. Dropkick by Ty Q. Ty Q signaling for something. A clothesline there by Europe. What is this? Pump handle drop. Pump handle drop there by Europe. And wait, now Europe is signaling for the end. Is he going for this power slam? Yes, he is. There it is. There's the power slam. Two, three. Europe has just picked up the victory. Europe picking up a victory over Ty Q here on this AWF vs. ACCE Super Show. Giving him a little bit of an advantage, perhaps, going into the chamber match at CyberSlam. Wait, that's Alberto Jr. Wait, now he's attacking Europe. He just attacked Europe from behind. Come on, that isn't right. Wait, what's going on in the back? Dynamite and Brock Manson are... These guys are sharing some words here. Oh! Brock Manson's a big punch! Look at this! Brock Manson taking the Dynamite! Wait a minute! Ty Q and Alberto Jr. now fighting in the ring! Dynamite is now fighting Brock Manson! Security's breaking them up! Oh my, wait a minute! That's the ACCE champion, Ice Dude! Ice Dude just speared up Alberto Jr.! My god! Can you believe this, ladies and gentlemen? All hell has just gone loose, oh my god! Ladies and gentlemen, take a few moments to pay respects to the unfortunate incident that happened last week in Boston. Thank you. And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, on AWF versus ACCE Super Show. Ladies and gentlemen, remember that this will serve as Uprising Episode 43 and Superstar Mayhem Episode 14. And here comes the ACCE United States Champion, NWO For Your Life. And this, and you guys already know this, this guy makes me sick. I can't stand him. Makes me sick to my stomach. And you know what? Tonight he's going up against Chris Hartford. And I hope Hartford kicks this guy's ass. I hope Nate the Great kicks this guy's ass at CyberSlam. You saw what he did on Superstar Mayhem. He brought the wife of Ben Hitman down to the ring and interviewed her about the personal life of herself and Ben Hitman. And Chris Hartford had enough, and he made it, and he came down to the ring to stop it. NWO actually went and tried to attack Chris Hartford, and Hartford fought back. Earlier tonight, we saw Hartford ask for this match. Jack Williams gave it to him, and we see Hartford, he's back. Chris Hartford back in the tights again. It's been years since Chris Hartford has stepped foot in an AWF ring. It's been years since he's had a match, and you gotta wonder, how is he going to fare up against NWO For Your Life, who's active every single week? And oh wow, you just, way to disrespect the legend, Chris Hartford. And Hartford now, look, dropkick. Oh, and a spear to the outside. You see the NWO, he was just staring at Hartford, slowly making his way back into the ring, keeping his eyes on Hartford. Wait, and the NWO now into the ring. And look at that! Enziguri knocks NWO right back to the outside. There's a double axe handle. And look at this. Big scoop slam on the outside. I was questioning whether Hartford still had it. He's done a damn good job so far. It looks like he hasn't even lost a step. Oh, big punch there. Hartford now on the top rope. And there's a drop kick. Chris Hartford, as you know, the brother of the number one contender for the AWF Championship, Ben Hitman. And there's a T-bone suplex. You guys are going to notice here tonight, Chris Hartford does a lot of moves that you're used to Ben Hitman doing. And that's because when Ben Hitman entered the car wrestling business, he actually modeled a lot of his moves off of his brother. There's a drop kick by NWO. A super kick. A big drop kick. Irish whip, and look at this German suplex there by the United States champion. There's a super kick, knocks Hartford to the outside. Oh my god, what a moonsault off the middle rope to the outside. Wait, look at this. A cross arm breaker on the outside. gonna try to break the arm of Chris Hartford? And look at this. Hartford gets out of it. Oh! Both men now back into the ring, and there's an elbow drop right to the back. Wait a minute. Oh my. A triple German suplex. And double underhook backbreaker. Up on the top rope, and oh, he went for a moonsault, but NWO for your life moved out of the way. And there's a back suplex by NWO for your life. And look at this big scoop slam. This would be a big win for NWO for your life if he can pick up the win here. Chris Hartford is a former AWF World Heavyweight Champion. A future Hall of Famer for sure. Double underhook backbreaker. Look at this. Oh my god! Two back suplexes and then a German. Wait a minute. What's Hartford doing? Now Hartford is up on the top rope. And there's a drop kick! A big frog splash! Oh, whatever he was going for there, NWO reversed it. And there's a super kick! And another super kick! Remember, NWO for your life has to go one-on-one with Nate the Great at CyberSlam. Wait a minute, look at this. A big super kick there. Wait a minute, look at this. Crossface is locked in. Hartford's got the crossface. Is he gonna make... For a second there, I thought he was gonna make NWO tap, but I guess not. Wait a minute! Crossface is back in! NWO is crawling to get to the ropes. Side headlock there by NWO and... Oh! I thought Hartford had NWO there with the crossface. I don't think he fully had that applied and allowed NWO to get out. There's a suplex. Big fist drop. Oh! Big super kick. This. He's got him up on his shoulders. And oh! What a move there! I really hope, ladies and gentlemen, that Hartford puts NWO away. The stuff NWO has said about the Hartford family is just so disrespectful. And wait a minute, is this gonna win it here? One. No. And now Hartford fighting back. Oh, what a neck breaker. What a German suplex. Hartford thinking maybe a cross face. Oh, knee in the gut there. Wait a minute. Stunner. He got the stunner. Stunner. Wait a minute. Look at this. Oh, come on. This is not even necessary. Another stunner. Two stunners there. One, two, three. NWO For Your Life has just picked up the victory over Chris Hartford. The United States champion just picked up a victory over Chris Hartford. And I must say it's impressive, but damn it, Hartford deserved to get retribution. And the two stunners was not necessary. We'll see how he fares when he goes up against Nate the Great at CyberSlam. What's he doing? Oh, no, he's got a steel chair. This is not right. Somebody's got to get out of here. Wait, there's Nate the Great. Nate the Great making the save here. Before NWO does any further damage. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to AWF vs. ACCE Super Show. And here comes the number one contender for the AWF Championship, Ben Hitman. We just seen his brother, right before the commercial break, lose to NWO For Your Life. Hopefully, Ben will have some better luck in his match. We're going to find out right now is he's going to team up with Sean Riley to go up against AJ Young and the AWF champion Danny Hardy. And there he is. Sean Riley, the number one contender for the Junior Heavyweight Championship. The first man to ever pin AJ Young in AWF / ACCE. And I know that pissed AJ Young off, like, to all levels. Which resulted in Sean Riley being jumped not once, but twice on AWF Old School. It was the second time that Ben Hitman actually came back to the ring and he made the save, which is why this match is happening here tonight.
Many folks ain't never heard of me, so I'm gonna introduce myself by using some hyperbole. I am that boy that talks a ton, but no one chatters back. They rather act like Vlad is acting spaz on rappers. Matter of fact, that's so real, I can't say it's like nah yet. Feelings that I caught made me feel that.
And there is the ACCE Junior Heavyweight Champion, AJ Young. You know, AJ Young, this is his first Uprising main event. And I know he loves that. Not that big fan of it. But you know, AJ Young wanted to jump Sean Riley after having a match with Ben Hitman. And you know what? That's just not, it's not right. And Ben Hitman, he fought for Sean Riley, which is, like I said before, why is this match going on? And I do know that Ben Hitman, while he has his frustrations with the AWF champion Danny Hardy, he has his frustrations obviously with the King, with the Revolution. AJ Young, obviously one of the main members of the Revolution. So I do not envy AJ Young in this match whatsoever. And there he is, ladies and gentlemen. The AWF World Champion, the leader of the Kings of Call. We heard him and Ben Hitman in the beginning of the night. They had some words for each other. And my goodness, ladies and gentlemen, that was epic right there. When if you didn't catch that, you gotta check that out. Danny Hardy, Ben Hitman, the final confrontation until their match it. CyberSlam, it was epic. And the referee calls for the bell. Ben Hitman going right up to AJ Young. Wait a minute. Tags in Danny Hardy right away. It looks like we're going to get a preview of the main event at CyberSlam. Or not. Look like Danny Hardy just got... He's only in there for a few seconds and then just tagged AJ Young back in. Thought we were going to have some kind of preview, but I guess not. But, you know, that's fine. we get to see Ben Hitman kick AJ Young's ass, which is always a good thing to see. And although Ben Hitman has not said anything, he definitely cannot be happy with what happened on Superstar Mayhem with his wife, NWO for your life, and his personal life being exposed like that. I mean, that's got to be killing him inside. I mean, I'm surprised he hasn't snapped yet, to be honest. But anyway, Sean Riley is now the legal man, and he's just taking it to AJ Young. Sean Riley very pissed off at AJ for the assault on the last Uprising. And can you blame the guy? Dropkick. But you know, I gotta give Sean Riley credit. Even after being attacked by AJ Young, he put on one hell of a match with Ben Hitman in the main event of AWF Old School. And there's Enziguri. What's this? AJ Young up on the top rope. His leg drop right in the back of the head. Oh my. Look at this. These drop kicks. Just like the one Sean Riley was doing. And Riley, what's he doing? Oh! Elbow right to the face. And he stomps right in the arm of AJ Young. He's got him up for a suplex. Then there it is. The big drop kick. Riley up on top. Oh! Missed the elbow drop. Wait a minute. AJ Young. Oh no, another leg drop to the back of the head. What's this? Oh my god! Oh, holy shit! I didn't think Danny Hardy could, do something like that. I am extremely impressed right there, ladies and gentlemen. That's definitely moment of the night right there. But regardless, Danny Hardy is taking it to Sean Riley. I guess that's all the high flying we'll be seeing from Danny Hardy probably for the next years. It's the only high flying we've ever seen from him. He's got him up, and I thought he was going to do a suplex, but dropped him right for a DDT. A full Nelson slam. Irish whip. Look at this German suplex. Just flip Sean Riley inside out. Wait a minute! He's knocked Ben Hitman off the apron! Look at these. I thought that was maybe Danny Hardy looking to get the victory there after knocking Hitman off the apron. Maybe capitalizing Sean Riley, but I think that was just a ploy to antagonize him. Wait, look at this. Ben Hitman he's just holding Danny Hardy for Sean Riley. Oh, wait a minute. Danny Hardy's moved out of the way, and Sean Riley accidentally kicked Ben Hitman right in the face. Oh, Hardy knocks the Hitman down again. Clothesline Sean Riley. This is not looking good for Riley and Hitman.
big clothesline. And another full Nelson slam. Kick in the gut. And a neck breaker. Uh-oh. Danny Hart, what's he got in mind? What is the AWF champion got in mind here for Sean Riley? And look at that. Oh! Olympic slam there. Uh-oh. He just threw up the symbol for the Kings of Claws, symbolizing the four men of the group. Wait, now Hardy up on the top rope. What? Oh my god! I guess the high flying didn't work that time. Wait a minute, Cobra Clutch! He had it locked in. Wait, oh! Big drop kick. Wait a minute! Riley accidentally took out the referee! My goodness, ladies and gentlemen. This match is all over the place. All hell is breaking loose. Wait a minute, look at this! Hot tag! Ben Hitman is in! Knocks AJ Young off the apron. An enziguri to Danny Hardy. It looks like Ben Hitman wants to get his hands on Danny Hardy after Danny Hardy just would knock him off the apron repeatedly in this match. It's a DDT. Oh, look at this. A triple German suplex. Big back suplex. Stomp in the gut. Reverse DDT. Uh-oh. Double underhook backbreaker. This right here, ladies and gentlemen, could be a preview for the main event of CyberSlam. If CyberSlam looks anything like this, we may be crowning a new AWF champion. Ben Hitman doing. He tagged Sean Riley back in. Oh! What a move there. There's the enziguri. Neckbreaker there by Sean Riley. And Ben Hitman tags himself back in. Double neckbreaker. Back suplex. Another back suplex. Now a German suplex. And what's Ben Hitman? Maple Knee! He got the Maple Knee! AJ Young goes right off the apron. 1, 2, 3. Ben Hitman has just pinned the AWF champion in this tag team matchup. Ben Hitman has just pinned Danny Hardy. I don't know about you guys, but I'm even more convinced that we may have a new AWF champion at the end of CyberSlam.
That new champion could be Ben Hitman. My goodness, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching this epic super show. We will see you at CyberSlam.
Hello, Sarah. I know you don't know who I am, but I know who you are. You see, taking you to a destination that, quite frankly, you're not going to like. And I really, really am sorry that I have to do this, but you see, money makes people do a lot of things. And, oh, shit. You see, what I'm doing, I hope one day you can forgive me. But he told me to do it. And if he, and I don't care what other people say, I do whatever I have to do to get the money. If that includes hurting people. So I'm sorry you have to be a victim of this. He told me to do this. He told me to bring you here. I don't know why. He told me specifically right here. And fuck! Isn't it, beautiful out here? Sarah, our ride ends. And it ends like this. I'm sorry, but he told me to do this.